My friends, so today we will cook a classic dish from Abruzzo region. Have a look.
Spaghetti alla chitandra con le pallottine. Traditional dish from Abruzzo region. Beef meatballs with spaghetti.
You got it right. It's spaghetti con le pallottine. Pallottine means very small balls, small meatballs. So you see, we also have in Italy our recipe for spaghetti with meatballs. It's a little bit different from what you know from the United States. Come closer, I explain to you what we will need for this. So basically, on the right-hand side, everything that is on this side, we need for the meatballs. In particular, starting with beef, we got here about 300 grams of fresh organic beef from my trusted butcher. That will be enough for two portions. And this beef, this minced beef, we will need to mix with the following ingredients. So about 50 grams of Parmigiano Reggiano. We also add a little bit of breadcrumbs, but not too much, really very little, because otherwise they will become too dry. Very important, we need fresh parsley and one clove of garlic. This will be cut very fine and also added to the minced beef together with one egg and a little bit of salt and pepper. So with this, we will create very small meatballs. They should not be bigger than 1 centimeter, and then put them into this 00 type flour, let them rest for a little bit and fry them later. Meanwhile, we will continue with our tomato sugo. So we will need for the sofrito onion, a little bit of carrot, perhaps half carrot, also this amount of celery. I also added a little bit of chili, but this is optional. I like a little bit spicy, and a little bit of basil leaves. We will also use our best friend, the olive oil. We got here our homemade extra virgin olive oil from our olives. And we will need spaghetti alla chitandra. This means these are spaghetti that are a little bit thicker than the standard spaghetti, and they have not this round shape, but instead you see this quadrato shape. And this is the typical pasta type that is used for this spaghetti dish, with which we'll use. And so these spaghetti are also fresh pasta. And that's it. A breaking news, one important ingredient I forgot for this meatball is this nutmeg, noce moscato. We will also make this a little bit small and add it into the meat. Okay, so first step is we will cut the garlic, and in the interest of time, I will use my magic move. Yeah, magic move worked well, so let's try the same for the parsley. Yeah, the magic move worked well also with the parsley, and let's try also with this nutmeg. Yeah, there we go, you see this has magic power. Let's continue now with the meat. So we will put the meat, actually it's a little bit too much for two portions, it's more than 300 grams, so that will be enough. We put the meat here inside, we will add the garlic. Wow, that's a lot of garlic, also big garlic clove, less would have been right also. We will add the parsley, we will add the muscat, but the nutmeg. And we will add one egg. We will add the breadcrumb and the Parmigiano. And now let's start mixing this. Oh, yeah. Of course, I have sanitized my fingers before I started this work. Really, really important. And keep doing so for a few minutes until it gets nice and firm, everything. And then we will shape the very small balls again. They should not be bigger than 1 centimeter. Italian pasta typically is eaten only with fork, no knife. That means the balls should be small enough that they don't have to be cut with a knife. Okay, so you see
The meat has been mixed. I will now add a little bit of salt and a little bit of black pepper. Continue mixing for another 1 minute and then we will do the meatballs. So the meat is now ready. You see, I take very, very little amount of meat and keep doing this exercise to get a small meatball with about 1 centimeter of size. Perhaps it is even too big, we will see. And I will keep doing so for the next, I would say, 10 minutes. It's a little bit of work. And I will put them directly into the flour because they will need to soak the flour on the outside. See?
My friends, there you are. So, very big milestone has been reached. You see these balls. Actually, I started big and I made them even smaller. 1 centimeter should be the magic size, the magic diameter. And you see, you now mix them together with the flour and let them rest for about 30 minutes, 1 hour. Meanwhile, we start already preparing the sugo. In the interest of time, I have already cut the onions and the olive oil should now be a little bit hot or getting hot now. So we will do the sofrito now. We will fry on medium flame the onions, the cut carrot, and the celery that I still have to cut into smaller pieces. So about this size. So we will fry this together for about 10 minutes on medium flame, and then we will add the tomato pulpa and let the sugo cook. And after about 15-20 minutes, we will fry the meatballs, the pallottine or polpettine, for about 5 minutes, and then add them also into our sugo. And that's basically the process. Okay, sofrito is doing well. I will add a little bit of chili. By the way, this chili, believe it or not, is from my garden. It's end of December and we still got some chilies that have survived the winter. You can now add also the tomato pulpa, and we will reduce slowly the heat to medium low flame, like this. Also add a few of these basil leaves, make them smaller. In any case, they will completely melt once the sauce has finished cooking. We also add some salt, there we go, a little bit of pepper, and stir a little bit, and soon we will also start. Look at this. Look at these polpettine. They are now resting with the flour around. Soon we will also start frying the polpettine, and then we will put them into the sugo. So you notice, meanwhile, I have changed the pot because the large pan will be easier later to stir around the spaghetti together with the meatballs, the polpettine. So next step is we will fry these polpettine for a few minutes, very shortly, in this olive oil. I just want to be sure I don't put too much flour inside, so I do it carefully, one by one, with my fingers. And then we will remove them, let them cool down a little bit, and finally cook them together with the sauce. Smells really good. Let me do a quality check. So after about 5 minutes, 6 minutes of frying. Look, this is done. Let's turn off this. So we let this cool down and then transfer the meatballs into the sugo. And meanwhile, I already start boiling the water. It's time now to add the meatballs, pallottine, into the sugo. And let this cook together for another 15-20 minutes, and then you're ready to eat. Pasta has 1 to 2 minutes of cooking time. So I just throw
spaghetti to boil in water. And let's have a look at the sugo. You see, it has become a little bit thick, so we will save some of the pasta water for later to mix this all together. Spaghetti alla chitandra have finished boiling. I will throw them in together with some pasta water, and we may add a little bit more depending how the sauce will develop. Let's stir a little bit. Spaghetti alla chitandra con le pallottine. Traditional dish from Abruzzo region. Beef meatballs with spaghetti. My friends, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video recipe. Actually, I did it for the first time today, and it looks pretty interesting. Let's see how it tastes like. By the way, down there in the description, you will find all the ingredients, and also feel free to put the thumb up if you like this video recipe. You can also subscribe to this channel. This is really just the very beginning. Buon appetito. Mm.